welcome to this short video where I'll be explaining the usage of the print function in Python. So let us start with the simplest of print statements. We'll print hello. I've written hello over here. Print hello, and I'll clear the console first of all. Right clear and press enter. The console is clear. Now run this. We got hello printed over here. Now, as you know, hello is a string, and that's why we have enclosed it within double quotes. You can also enclose within single quotes. Python allows the use of both single quotes and double quotes for strings. I again got it printed. Now, what happens if I use one more print statement, if I use two print statements? Let me try. Print line 1 and then print line 2. Run the command. They are printed on different lines. So the print statement adds a new line character automatically. And if you don't want this, we can change it using the end argument. Let's say I write n equal to space. I put in a space over here. Now run this. See, line 1, then space, then line 2. So whatever you give at the end, in the end argument, is added after the printing of that. After the end of the print statement, everything in the print statement is printed, and then whatever you write at the end is printed. You can add more characters if you like. This is the end. Now what's this? Line 1, this is the end, and then line 2. And of course you can simply write slash n and it will work as before. Default value for n is slash n, and the line breaks automatically. Then there is the other variable called SEP, separator. How does the separator work? What's this? 1, 2, 3. I'm printing 3 different values. Now, they are separated by space. SEP default value is space. If I want something else, I can define it here. See, double quotes, and I've written comma. Now we'll get comma in between the characters. What happens if I print another line? 4, 5, 6. It's only new line. The n works as before. We can define that if we want, and I'm defining the top one. N is equal to, again, put a semicolon here. Now what's this? 1, 2, 3. At the end of the line, got a semicolon. So SEP and end separator and end can be defined together. Now let us try and define some variables and print their values. So we'll define two variables, x equal to 10, y equal to 12, and print x comma y. Clear the console. Run the program now. So we got 10 space 12. Python allows the use of printf style formatting statements. You remember this percent %d, percent %f, etc. Can we use this here? Let's try. So I'll give person D, comma, person D. Then I need to give a percent over here, and I've written 10. What's this? Person D. See, we got 10 here. If I want another one, I can write another person D and provide one more number here. So we got 10 and 20. There we are. We can give format specifiers and give the length for this. Now I've written 5D here. See, this is shift. We've got 3 spaces here and 2 characters. So 5 says that we are specifying the width over here, and it will work. We can also give format characters. See, if I give 0 over here, then extra spaces will be filled with zeros. I can do the same here. 05. Python allows the use of octals, hexadecimal numbers as well. Percent O will define the octal number. 10, and this is the octal equivalent of 10. Octal value of percent D is percent O. Now you can write 10 2 times over here. Now what's this? Octal value of 10 is 1 2. This is place value of 8 and this is place value of 1, so this is 10. Similarly, we can use X for hexadecimal. X value of percent D is percent X. I'll make this 15. So we should get F for the hexadecimal. See, X value of 15 is F. And since I've written a small x, therefore it is in lowercase. I can use capital F to get a capital X to get a capital F there. See, we got a capital F. Try 214. Check this out, is D6. That is 254. Is FE 255 will be perfect. Now we can use the exponential formatting. Let's try this. 115. I've written percent E here. It's 1.15 into 10 to the power 2. Again, we can work it out like before. a capital E will be written upper caps, capital letters. You can also have decimal numbers. I'll have to use percent of volume. 0.150 is this to the power minus 1. So we did this. Now we can have the position formatting as it is. What's this? Print x is equal to x5d y is equal to y8.2f. I'm just giving a floating point format. I'm going to use the format function of the string class and pass the values x equal to 4. Let's say I give y is equal to 7. Now watch. X will be printed here and y will be printed here. There, x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 7.00, as we said. Then instead of format, we can also use the F command, which is like this: print F. Now this is very flexible. We will do this, and what shall we print? X, I'll put the value of x here, and y is equal to 10 and y is equal to 12. I can put x equal to x here, x equal to 10 and y is equal to 12. You can actually put any formulas over here as well. So x plus y is equal to x plus y, and this will be evaluated. So what's this? X plus y is equal to 22. You can use anything. X to the power y is x star star y. Okay. This is 10 to the power 10 to the power 12. You can use it here also. Say 10 to the power y. You can put curly braces over here as well. So maybe I can put a slash in here so it comes on a new line. There you are. 10 to the power 12 is this, that works something like this. Print x is equal to placeholder at 0, y is equal to placeholder at 1. You can also repeat it, so x is equal to 0, I'm putting it once again, dot format, and I write x comma y. What happens now? See, x is repeated at both the positions. This is just about sufficient, and I'd like you to practice all this. And for more, you can connect, you can call me at my number on WhatsApp or join the classes. Okay, that's it.